क्या नाम है तुम्हारा?
वही जो हर औरत की जुबान पे होता है।
मर्द बनो, toughen up. Why don't you grow a pair? We have a million different ways of telling men that to actually be men, they need to have this 56 inch ki chhati. But where does this idea come from?
मंगल का खून कोई लेमन सोडा नहीं जिससे विजय जैसे ओंगे पोंगे अपनी प्यास बुझाते फिरे।
Researchers have found that humans evolved as a gender equal species. In hunter-gatherer societies, men and women had different but equal roles. Both found food, raised children, and made decisions for the family and community. Around 10 to 12,000 years ago, the invention of agriculture changed that. When humans settled on particular parcels of land and began accumulating resources, they needed to defend their homesteads from other humans. As a result, the emphasis on physical strength increased, and those communities with the physically strongest men became the most powerful and prosperous. Through the centuries, the importance of men physically protecting their societies grew stronger, especially as warfare became central to societies and nation-states. But in the 19th century, this notion of manliness shifted in the Victorian era as economies focused more on industry. Men were supposed to be tough to manage grueling work schedules, while women were supposed to be patient to manage family life in the household. This Victorian idea of masculinity impacted how we viewed men in India. During colonial rule, Britishers frequently ridiculed the masculinity of Indian men, describing them as effeminate and weak. Indian men's lack of manly characteristics was often used as a justification for the more courageous Brits to rule over them. And so for Indian men, the emphasis on physical strength and virility became intertwined with national pride and defeating colonial tyranny. Even after independence, this idea remained strong. It was reflected in Hindi cinema through the trope of the nationalist hero of the 50s and 60s, who used his khoon paseene ki mehnat to carry the burden of the newly independent country.
Hum tumhari daya ke bhikari nahi hain. Mard haath phaila ke bheek nahi mangta, haath dhoa ke sarf mangta sarf.
By the 70s, as people became disillusioned because of the corruption of the Indian government, this tough guy trope was reinforced as the angry young man who was fighting an unfair system. While romantic heroes like Shah Rukh Khan and Aamir Khan did represent a more sensitive masculinity in the 90s and early 2000s, box office numbers have shown that the biggest hits throughout the years have still been the dishoom dishoom action flicks with the typical macho hero, his garam khoon and his savior complex. In our everyday lives, the pressure on men to be tough starts as early as school and college, when boys are encouraged to become physically tough through sports and other outdoor activities. Later, they're socialized to pursue manly fields, engineering, while the creative pursuits are left to women. And society reinforces what it means to behave manly. For instance, studies have found that men are perceived to be of a lower status or less competent if they express emotions such as sadness, display vulnerability, or ask for help.
Hey, aansu ponch dalo. Mard log roya thodi karte hain.
Psychologists link this social conditioning to pent-up anger, displays of violence, depression, and even higher rates of suicide among men. So if this notion of being a mard causes so much dard, why do we hold on to it so tightly? It's time we stop viewing tough men as superior and rethink what toughness itself means. Going through childbirth is tough. Standing up to a family that rejects your sexuality is tough. It's tough to do paid work for the sake of supporting your family, but it's equally tough to do unpaid work that goes unacknowledged. So let's not assume there's only one way to be tough or strong or the pillar of support for a community. Instead, it might be healthier to admit that strength appears in various ways, and the strongest among us are those who accept that diversity and don't define strength as per gender stereotypes. That's it for the latest video in our Overthinking It series. If you like our content, please don't forget to share it, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you stay updated.